Hey, what's up, everybody? Thank you guys for tuning in. Like always, hit that like button, subscribe to my channel. And also, if you guys are new, make sure you hit the notification bell as well, so when I do post my videos, you guys won't miss out. Also, appreciate you guys too that's already subscribed, that's a part of my community. Appreciate you guys helping my channel grow, allowing me to put these videos out here for you guys and put these updates and things. Also, make sure you join my Patreon page or become a patron at simcastpodcastpatreon.com. Different perks, different tiers, a lot of behind the scenes videos and things I post on there, some exclusive stuff that you can't get on my channel. Also, check out my channel on my merch page that I have. I have a lot of merchandise, a lot of t-shirts and hats and outfits and things that I've created. The link should be in the description. Also, it should be somewhere where I've posted that so you guys can see it. But yeah, go ahead and check it out. So, for today's video, my Chef Talking reviews, I will be reviewing Batman, Caped Crusader, a new animated series headed by Bruce Timm. If you guys are familiar with the Batman animated series, it's pretty much the same people behind it, the same minds and everything. It's just almost, I say, like a continuation story, or not a reboot, but just a reimagining of the Batman story. Now, we all know the one in the 92, I believe, the Batman animated series went for a couple seasons, had a different style. It was always unique because it had the dark look to it. You know, it had the gangster element to it with the 1950s style a little bit, you know, with the suits and everything and with the cops, pretty much capturing the essence of Gotham that we know, especially from the Tim Burton movies. So I see that Bruce Timm, I guess he was offered to do it another animated series or another Batman animated series to continue that story. But he figured, you know, we can explore other options. We could do more with just like redoing the story, but we could do more with the characters. So with the Caped Crusader, we see that we have like pretty much a different take on all these characters. It's pretty much like a noir kind of feel. You know, that 1940s style, you know, coppers and things like that, which is cool. Yeah, the first character that we got introduced to from his rogue gallery basically was the Penguin. We got introduced to the Penguin early, and we all see that it was a gender swap. Now, a lot of critics, they don't like it. They feel like they should have went with just a regular Penguin, regular story. But nowadays, when people are creating a different, you know, a take on these characters, sometimes we get a gender swap. Sometimes we get a race swap. But it's always still the characters at his core. We still always have the, you know, we still have Penguin. You know, it's no difference. It's just a woman. But you see that she still is as vicious as the Penguin. Got the toys, got the umbrellas and everything. So like that. Also, Catwoman. That's another character. It looked like they went with the old school Julie Newmar with her Catwoman. Because I see it looks like she got that costume that you know, from the comics, her original costume, and not the black leather or the black tights, you know, that we usually see, like with the you know, with the Tim Burton movies, Batman Returns, or either with Halle Berry, you know. But so this is like a new refresher to see a different version of this character. So it's cool. We see the little scene, I got the clip posted now, where Bruce Wayne actually first meets Selina Kyle. You know what I mean? At the auction, I think they like either auctioning or just showing off his mother's pearls. They have a little, you know, little bit of words, a little flirty with that. And then they story progress in that episode. So it was cool to see that they still got these characters, especially the ones that we all know and love and recognize. You know, Catwoman, she was a big character that was in the animated series, the old one. So it was good to see her again. And then speaking of, you know, original characters, we also had Pennyworth. You know, we all know him as Alfred, but see, since this is a reimagining of a younger Bruce Wayne or a younger Batman, it's almost like he's starting out. He's almost just now trusting Alfred, but he's been calling him Pennyworth the whole time. You know, we have 10 episodes that's streaming now. So if you watch them, spoilers ahead. If you didn't watch it, like I said, spoilers ahead if you didn't watch it. But I suggest that you have to watch it in order to catch the whole story. So by the end of the season, we see the progression of him in Pennyworth, where now he's calling him Alfred. Now he's more closer to him now. You know what I mean? So that was cool. I see they have a different look for Alfred. But, you know, like I said, I like it. It's supposed to be another reimagining of the show. So, you know, they have different versions of the comics, different versions of the media, different versions of the movie. So they don't always got to be the same look, same size, or same suit and stuff like that. So I'm glad that they don't just fall into the same trap of just making it cookie cutter, making it the same, and that's it. And no originality. No creativity, just the same cookie cutter characters that we usually see, you know. And then speaking of that, it's cool that, you know, in the old animated series, the show was mostly highlighted or mostly about Batman. It was about him and his struggles and his character and with his rogues and everything. But now in this new show with the Caped Crusader, we see that they are showing more of Jim Gordon. You know, we see more of Bullock, and now we see Renee Montoya. You know, like I said, we see Renee Montoya. I believe we seen her in The Flash. We seen that character live action. She's been in the comics. I believe she's been in the Batman animated series, but now we actually get to see her as a detective. Like I said, since this is an early Batman, he's kind of like on the run from the police because they still think, you know, he's just a vigilante to them. He's just a myth. They don't know who he is or what he's about. They just know he shows up. So that's cool to see Renee being the detective that she is. You have Barbara Gordon. You know, we all know her as Batgirl. We have a race swap with her and this character, as well as her father, Commissioner Gordon. Which is cool, you know, but I see she have the red hair. So it must be like the take from the comics, though, like the first Batgirl or the first Batwoman, where she had the red hair, you know. So interesting to see, is she going to become Batgirl or will she become the Oracle? You know, that was her moniker as well. So let me know in the comments what you guys think and what your thoughts on her character. And maybe, you know, season two. You never know what will her role be. And then Harvey Dent. We all know who Harvey Dent is. He runs running for office, running for mayor. But in the midst of all of that, we know the story. I think he pretty much accepted campaign funds from the mob. Didn't want to pay or didn't want to follow the rules with them. And ended up getting acid thrown in his face. I believe it was a different origin story in the original Batman animated series. But this one, I think it's like close to the comics a little bit, but he had acid thrown in his face. So then we see, you know, in the episode that he's in where he's making that transformation, we can kind of see that he's struggling with himself, with the duality. You know, with the two-faced character. So it's cool to see that, how they put that together and put the pieces together, as well as showing how Bruce Wayne pretty much kind of pushed him a little bit to the edge without considered, like Alfred said, without considered a man, but just like he just trying to look at the criminal type of thing. So, but yeah, but shout out for them for making this character interesting as well. And like I said, spoilers, if you guys haven't watched the first 10 episodes of this first season, where we see Harvey Dent's transformation, we see what happens in the end. I love his ending story. So that's cool. Then also, like I said, just to talk more about the show, Caped Crusader. Like I said, I love the way they're going with it. I'm interested to see what other characters they're gonna have. You know, and not forgetting about Harley Quinzel. Harley Quinn, for everybody that don't know. We see she was introduced as a psychiatrist, as Bruce Wayne's psychiatrist, and also the psychiatrist in Arkham. You know, we all know the story. One of my favorite stories in the original animated series, where we see how Harley Quinn became who she was. You know, she fell in love with the Joker. She fell in love with who he was and kind of had sympathy for him. And then to pretty much impress him, she created the character of Harley Quinn to counterpart his Joker, which was real cool. So in this show, we see that almost the same, except the Joker's not present. But and spoilers ahead for we to see, if you guys haven't watched this, the first 10 episodes, we have a big reveal in the end of the series or the season. But you know, for right now, Harley Quinn, she pretty much has been living a double life where she's treating criminals and pretty much putting them in their place, kind of torturing them a little bit of what they're today, pretty much like whatever their villain is, she kind of torturing them to that and teaching them a lesson. But we see that she dons the outfit. It's not the iconic red and black, you know, that we saw in the original animated series, but it's also still a jester or a Harlequin-esque outfit. So, and that's cool. And I believe, look at my notes, and I believe that's playing Harley Quinn is Jamie Chung. So, again, another race swap or another version of this character. I don't see anything wrong with it. But also, let's shout out Batman. Now, for you Batman fans, we all know the definitive live action Batman, in my opinion, is Michael Keaton. We all know, or I know, that he's the definitive Batman, just like Christopher Reeve is the apex Superman. So when it comes to the animated series or the animated Batman, we all know that that Kevin Conroy, he's the apex. So shout out to this guy, voice actor, I believe is Hamish Linklater. So he's voicing the Bruce Wayne Batman character. I feel like he's doing a great job. He's capturing that that gritty, that dark Batman. Like he can kind of turn it on and turn it off. So it's cool. And then we see the straight Bruce Wayne, the straight man, you know, like we always see, just a regular guy, rich man, just the face of Wayne Enterprises type of thing. So they did a great job of doing the duality of his character too, and seeing, like I said, as an early take on the Dark Knight. So we see him being a detective. We see the old school like radios and things that he's used. His grappling gun is even different, and even the Batmobile, almost looked the same, but it kind of looks like the Matt Reeves Batmobile from the movie. And I believe he serves as the executive producer on the show anyway, so it makes sense. But Batmobile's cool. We see little jokes here and there where somebody, people make reference to it like, now that's a cool car, which it is. Batmobile has always been, you know. So, yeah, so this show is full of, we got the mobsters, we got this, the dark Gotham like we know. And also, they take it a little step further for us mature audiences, and pretty much like, you know, they kind of breaking the little rules a little bit that they have from the original, where we see Batman holding a gun or using it, or, you know, or certain things like that, which is all right, because in different interpretations of the Batman, he's just that, you know. So they're doing a great job. And then also, like I said, show full of mobsters and gangsters and everybody double crossing, crooked cops, a Bullock and his partner, Flash. We see that Bullock is a crooked cop in this show. But last time, Bullock, he was like a part of the working with Jim Gordon and everything like that. Always trying to figure out where Batman is. Didn't like Batman, but he still worked with him anyway. So it's cool that now we have another interpretation of Bullock. And also the partner from the comics as well, Flash. Don't know too much about this character, but I believe it's voiced by Gary Anthony Williams. You guys familiar with his work? He's Uncle Ruckus, he plays on the Boondocks, amongst a lot of other movies and roles and shows that he's been on. He's a good actor. I like him. But yeah, so, and then speaking of that, I believe they work for, and we all know him, Rupert Thorne. He works for him, or they work for them, as well as how Two-Face or Harvey Dent, he was working with him, taking money from him. And we know Rupert Thorne was a big character or a big player in the original Batman animated series. But like I said, his design is different here. He looked like he's probably a younger version of himself. He's not as big as he was, but he's still the same Thorne that we know. Still the same gangster, same, loan shark slash, basically, like I said, mobster. So that's refreshing to see, like I said, these characters, you know, as well as some of the rogues too. Like we got a chance to see Clayface, Ghost of Gotham we saw. We saw Firebug. I'm not familiar with that character. I had to look more in the comics or looking, in other media or something like that to kind of find out who that character is. If you guys know, let me know in the comments who he is. But yeah. So it's cool to see different people or different roles that he has to fight other than the original. But like I said, for these 10 episodes, the story kind of went along. It had one main storyline that we ended up getting to, which was the transformation of Harvey Dent to Two-Face. And then what we saw in the end, spoilers, if you guys haven't watched it, last seconds or the last minutes of the show or the series of episode 10, the big reveal, we see a scene of people laughing, see that face, the smile, and then we see a guy look like he's injecting them with a smile. And right before the show it ends, it fades to black, we see some figure with a syringe saying it's just perfect. Now, we all know who that is. That's Joker. Just wonder, though, which Joker, which version is this Joker going to be? And is he going to be a main antagonist the same way as the Joker was in the original animated series? But I believe it's not going to be voiced by Mark Hamill. Just on the strength that since Kevin Conroy died, he felt like since he was Batman and he's the Joker to his Batman, he wouldn't feel right to be Joker to somebody else's Batman, which is understandable because he did a hell of a job as the Joker and always continued, if it's in the movie shows or whatever, he always did great. So like I said, just interested to find out which Joker and who's going to voice him. And like I said, which version of this one is going to be. And will he be working with Harley Quinn? Is he going to be part of another mob or anything, or he just going to be on his own? But let me know in the comments what your thoughts, your theories. Let me think. Let me know what you guys think. So, yeah. So, like I said, I love the first 10 episodes. Don't know if it's going to have more episodes in the season, or that's just the first 10 episodes in the first season, and that's it, going to the next one. So season two come around. I can't wait to see where they're going to go with it, how the story going to play out, what's going to happen with Harvey, and anybody else that we saw. Are they going to get even bigger? Or, you know what I mean? Or are they roles going to be lesser? Or if we're going to see other characters as well? Interested to see Mr. Freeze, since I believe that episode in the original series, I think, was like the top episode, or they won awards for that episode for Mr. Freeze, for his origin story and everything. So, like I said, just can't wait to find out. But yeah, so that's pretty much it, guys. Thank you guys for tuning in. Like I said, I love the show. I might have to watch it all over again just to see it. But yeah. So yeah, let me know what you guys think. The updates coming soon. I will be doing some reviews on certain episodes. Let me know what you guys want me to review on too, and I can do that as well. But yeah, so I'm gonna post it on my page already. I'm gonna be posting clips and things like that. But yeah, so make sure you go check it out. So till next time, guys, hit that like button, subscribe to my channel. Peace.